I'm very honored to be joined by Katelijne de Gooyer. You're the Communications Manager of Victim International, and you've been working really hard for the past few months
yes.
to make this show come together and make it happen.
Yes.
Katelijne, what's it like to stand here right now with the first day almost coming to an end?
I'm standing here with a great feeling because it's been a fantastic first day. The show looks incredible and there's a lot of visitors, so yeah, we're very happy.
Well, let's explore that a bit. Let's imagine someone's watching who's never heard of Victim Asia 2018 before. What is this place? Where are we?
Victim Asia is the world's largest animal feed processing exhibition.
Yeah.
And we also have rice milling and flour milling, aqua feed and pet food. So you can find anything you need here on our exhibition. So
yeah.
From machines to additives to all kinds of things.
Yeah, so that's the trade show. We're here with the nice room in the heart of this trade show. You see it around us. Later in this live update, I'll take you around quickly on a quick tour. So stay tuned for that. Let's talk some numbers. How many exhibitors do we have around here?
We have over 220 exhibitors from 30 countries.
Yeah.
And it's the largest number of exhibitors that we've had so far.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And this is the 12th edition, so it's it was a nice goal for us.
Yeah.
And visitor-wise, we are close to 4,000 visitors on the first day, which is also a very high number.
It's a new record?
It's a new record, yes.
All right,
absolutely.
So congratulations to you and your colleagues and everybody
yes.
who's here in the room around us. We're
Thank
doing
you.
Great, we're growing. What is driving that growth, do you think? Why does everybody wants to be here at the BiTech these days?
Because this is the only event in the world where you can, which is specialized in animal feed processing, where you can see the machines, you can feel them, you can touch them. So that's very attractive for people who work on a daily basis with these machines.
Finally, the design drawings come to life. Right?
Yes,
you
exactly.
can physically stand
can physically,
in and
yeah.
underneath
yes.
and around the
exactly.
machines here
yes.
on the trade show
yes.
floor. Now, besides all these exhibitors, 220 exhibitors, there's also a lot of stuff going on upstairs. What's there?
Yes, we have six conferences in total. There's three today, and there's two tomorrow, and then one on Thursday. And these conferences are all connected to the exhibition, so about animal feed processing, about aqua feed, pet food, grappas, which is the grain
the
and
milling.
Flour and rice milling. And we also have a special conference for which is more focused on the world feed perspective. So how do several countries look at the animal feed industry?
Yeah, so and we've had some of those speakers here in the studio today summarizing their talk. So if you're curious to find out about them, make sure you check out the Victim International YouTube channel, because all those videos will appear there in the next 24 hours. So a lot of knowledge being shared. Have you heard already? What are the key topics? What are the hot topics that are being discussed in the conference? What have you heard? You basically didn't have a chance to go up
yet. I didn't have
yet.
A chance, unfortunately, to go upstairs yet and sit in one of the sessions.
All right, so we'll take the task upon us to make sure we can
yes.
tell you on day three, when we have you back here to
Absolutely.
Reflect on the show,
yes.
what the key topics are. Now, finally, this trade show has been around for a few years. You say the 12th edition.
Yes.
But we also see some innovations. Obviously, the newsroom, well, enough about that. People are witnessing that as it unfolds. But what is yes. the other key innovation that is here at the trade show?
That is the business matchmaking program.
How does that work?
We introduced it last year in Cologne, so some of the people already experienced the program. We've set up a program where exhibitors can meet visitors and visitors can meet exhibitors.
Yeah.
And they can do that very efficiently. So we have an online tool where you can contact someone you would like to have an appointment with. And so you can set up the appointment and then meet here. So you can plan your appointments and you can get the most out of the exhibition.
Exactly. It's taking being here in Bangkok even a step further, not just relying on walk-ins or occasional
yes.
meetings, which happen a lot too, by the
yeah,
way.
Absolutely.
We see that all around us. But so it's pre-planned doing business. What are some of the responses you hear from people participating in this program?
They're very positive because they get to meet people they may normally not meet, or someone is very busy on the stand, so they don't have time And this way, they get to meet more people that
otherwise they might have not.
Yeah.
Good. Nice innovation. And we're going to try, because we're live for you every day with this daily update, we're going to try to fetch some people out of those matchmaking programs and let them share their experience with you as well. Now, finally, Katelijne, we have two more days ahead of us.
Yes.
What are some of the highlights that you're looking forward to yourself?
Well, hopefully the same day as today for the next 2 days, and that a lot of people can enjoy the conferences as well and learn and and share information and knowledge.
All right. Well, yeah. I hope that works out as well. And as said, I promise our audience you'll be back with us on Thursday, 3 o'clock, to reflect together on whether this came true or not.
Yes. Okay.
Well, thank you for being with us.